Chapter 397, Breaking the Marriage Arrangement. Lan Yunzu, the descendant of the Thousand Carpriver, a famous genius of a distant cloud, and a beauty that captivated the hearts of many young men. The static stream royal lord and Liu Baiqiu were dumbfounded since they didn't expect that Li Kai was actually Lan Yunzu's fiancée despite her having so many suitors. This news was really shocking to the two of them. A girl like Lan Yunzu was a high and above existence, but now it turns out that she was actually betrothed to a nameless person. So what if she is the Thousand Carpriver's descendant? Li Kai responded in a lazy manner, even fairies from the nine heavens are nothing special. Protector Zhao almost vomited blood from anger, but he calmed down in order to successfully cancel this marriage. Young friend, today, our Thousand Carpriver came with sincerity. He even lowered his prideful attitude even more. As long as young friend is willing to cancel this marriage, everything will be easily negotiable. Treasures, immortal gifts, the finest of items. Our Thousand Carpriver can discuss giving you all of these things. And if you want to, you can even join our sect and become a disciple. The recruitment for an emperor's lineage disciple was extremely stringent. Protector Zhao's rhetoric did show that their sect came with goodwill. Yes, that does indeed show some good faith. Li Kai sometimes had a really bad temperament. He was the type who liked soft attitudes, not hard ones. If the opponent was arrogant, then he would be even more aggressive. Li Kai then said with a smile, but to me, sincerity is not just about treasures or immortal gifts. If you really want to cancel this marriage, let her come and tell me in person, then I might think about it. It isn't a bunch of old men from your Thousand Carpriver getting married, so why are you all taking charge of this? Of course, this marriage was just an accident to Li Kai. If the girl really wanted to cancel this engagement, he personally didn't mind it at all. However, if the Thousand Carpriver wished to forcefully cancel it, then he wanted to torture them a bit. Protector Zhao was very exasperated and really wanted to teach the stinky brat a lesson, but he was still able to hold back. Li Kai began losing interest in an old man like Protector Zhao and no longer wished to debate any further. Protector Zhao became angrier and angrier, but he still managed to maintain a friendly tone as he said with seriousness, "You can think about it. This is a great opportunity for you. Let the static stream royal lord pass on your response once you have figured it out." After Protector Zhao left, Li Kai smiled and murmured, "Immortal Emperor Qian Li's future generations are actually not bad." Despite Protector Zhao still acting arrogantly, in the end, he still didn't use his background to bully people and forcefully dissolve this marriage. Otherwise, Li Kai would have been happy to teach these old men a lesson in Immortal Emperor Qian Li's stead. "You. Since when did you become Fairy Zhu's fiancé?" After the Protector left, Liu Baiqiu asked. She was no longer able to bear her curiosity. Rumor has it that many people had proposed to Lan Yunzu, but all of them were rejected, so this fiancé appearing out of nowhere was really too sudden. "I picked up this marriage arrangement on the road." Li Kai smiled and said. Liu Baiqiu was out of words. Lan Yunzu was one of the prettiest and most powerful goddesses in the distant cloud, so how could becoming her fiancé be so easy? If one could pick up such a thing by just walking on the road, then countless people would have been walking non-stop. If Liu Baiqiu knew that this marriage arrangement really was picked up by accident, then she definitely would be even more aghast. The Thousand Carpriver coming to cancel the marriage was only a small matter to Li Kai. He still stayed on the small island and waited for the right opportunity to enter the lost mythical island. And during this period of time, the Thousand Islands became busier and busier as more experts from the great powers rushed here. The sky of the islands was filled with flying treasures and huge beasts heading towards the ocean. Moreover, every day, the sky of the islands was filled with blood energy. The auras of heavenly sovereigns and heavenly kings towered in the sky since countless great characters from the big powers had personally come. Such a grand scene caused the island's cultivators to feel nervous for the inevitable storm. In order to avoid being caught up in this trouble, after the royal lord received Li Kai's order, he immediately evacuated his disciples and even the residents of the islands. Especially when one great power after another appeared, the static stream royal lord became even more cognizant of the eventual storm, so he hurried the evacuation process. Of course, this evacuation was only temporary. They would come back after the trouble was over. During this period, constant explosions could be found each day out in the sea. Sometimes, the earth would even shake as huge tidal waves reached the sky itself. At the Lost Island's location, dazzling radiance was a common sight. Some emanated from treasures, and some were immortal lights that came from inside the Lost Island. It is not just the distant cloud anymore. Even great characters from the Misty Field, Nether Border, and Green River have arrived. Liu Baiqiu had been keeping contact with the outside and constantly informed Li Kai. She couldn't help herself from worrying. In the last few days, some jewel sovereigns have arrived and almost flipped the ocean over. Should we leave this place first? No. Li Kai shook his head and then said with a cheerful countenance, "If jewel sovereigns have come, then we can go take a look." Li Kai and Liu Baiqiu went to the sea once more. Compared to the last visit, the island was a lot more chaotic this time. Many flying treasures were stopped above the ocean with gigantic vessels hovering in the sky along with pavilions and vying mountains. There were many cultivators, including great characters, who wished to reach the lost mythical island, but some of them were also here just to watch the fun. Some rode strange-looking beasts while others were on flying treasures. Some were situated above the sea while there were also those who chose to just stay in the water. And there were many great changes within the fog-shrouded Lost Island itself. Its dome had seven colored rays beaming outward with continuous transformations. Sometimes, they took the form of majestic sceneries, divine beasts, or just disappeared altogether. Magnificent cries emanated from the island along with beastly howls as if there was a fierce creature imprisoned on the island. Even the mist surrounding the island had changed and turned into a faint crimson mist. This bloody color was from the remnants of those cultivators who wished to cross the mist. They intended to forcefully enter the island, but were devoured and turned into a bloody mist in just a second, becoming part of this never-dissipating layer. Li Kai couldn't help but narrow his eyes as he gazed at the great changes taking place on the lost island and didn't speak for a long time. Now, right outside of the fog, the great powers had started to divide the ocean into their own camps and built small territories on the surface to house their armies. What was even more impressive was that above the mists, there were great characters with divine rings around them in all cardinal directions. The auras emitted by their bodies caused all the great demonic beasts in the sea to run. They were surely unfathomable characters. Some were heavenly sovereigns, some were heavenly kings. They were all mighty rulers of their own countries or sects who rarely show themselves, but all of them appeared right here in the present. Nighthawker Sect, Coiling Dragon Country, Sky Towering Gate. Looking at the camps from all of these powers, Liu Beiqiu could recognize their insignias and murmured, "So many top-level sects are here. Not just great powers, even a few old undyings who didn't want to come into being are also here right now along with a few ancestors." At this time, a person suddenly appeared right next to Li Kai and continued on, "Yesterday, the Ironstone Valley's ancestor also came. He wanted to force his way into the Lost Island, but alas, he was instantly rendered into a bloody mist.